Sisters, it's great to see all of you. I know what you're thinking. It's not like we're really neighbors. We don't live next to each other on the same street, but you don't have to live next to someone to be their neighbor. A neighbor can be anyone you see or talk to, even me. Everyone is your neighbor. Everyone is worthy of your care and your kindness and your compassion. And that's what we're talking about, compassion. And with God's help, we can show compassion to everyone around us. We can care for the people in our neighborhood.
Yes. Hey, you better hurry and get in on this.
What is this?
Miss Franklin is selling her yard.
What?
Yeah, she's having a yard sale.
John.
No. She said she was ending her yard sale at 4 o'clock and I could come by and take whatever I wanted. She was just going to get rid of it anyway.
Was there other stuff in her yard?
Yeah, there were like some tables in the driveway with some antiques and clothes on it. I think she was cleaning out her attic. I have never seen so many shoulder pads and gold buttons in my life.
That was the stuff she was selling.
No, it is called a yard sale, Brandon, where you sell your yard.
Or where you sell old stuff in your yard.
You sure?
Absolutely.
John!
It's Miss Franklin. You never saw me. Get what you can!
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the So-and-So Show. I'm Brandon.
I'm John.
You gonna join the show today, or do we need to give you some more time?
Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm trying to buy a new vacuum cleaner, because, you know, there's dirt everywhere around here.
No kidding.
It's impossible to know which vacuum cleaner to get. There's just so many of them. You know what I miss?
What?
Door-to-door salespeople.
Ooh.
Yeah, they just show up at your door and they tell you exactly what you need, whether you need it or not, and you just can't say no.
Actually, you can just say no.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, I miss them. You never see them around anymore. Who's there?
Just a moment of your time. I'm a door-to-door salesman.
Yes! Please welcome someone who sells stuff. You can come in. I said you could... Never mind. Hi.
I'm Marie Lohman with Door to Doors. And have I got a deal for you?
Come on in.
Yeah, go on in.
Have a seat.
Don't mind if I do. Right. Don't mind if I do.
Okay. We know who you are, so tell us, what do you sell?
Doors are my name. Selling is my game. Except my name is actually Murray, not Doors. That's just my tagline for my business. Door to Doors.
Yeah. Okay. And what do you sell?
I'm a door-to-door salesman.
Yeah, no, we got that. But what do you sell? Do you sell, like, crazy cleaning products that wash out three-year-old raspberry jam stains? Or rags that can soak up an entire pool? Or vacuum cleaners? Because I could really use a vacuum cleaner.
I'm a door-to-door salesman. Wait here.
Oh.
Wait here.
Okay.
I thought it made sense.
Oh. Okay, so you sell...
Good afternoon. I'm Murray with Door to Doors. With our exclusive direct door-to-door delivery system, we replace your door with one of your neighbor's doors. So call Door to Doors today.
Wait, you sell doors?
Yes! For only $25, I will trade your door with any door from the homes in your neighborhood.
Wait. So did you take this door from one of my neighbors?
I didn't just take it, John. I traded my front door for it.
Oh.
Do you like it? It's part of our Tuscan open air concept.
Yeah, but Murray, this door is really old.
It's vintage.
Okay, but the screen is ripped and missing in some places.
Open air.
What if it gets cold?
Build a fire.
Or bugs.
Mm.
We built our house in the bugs' home. Why shouldn't they live in ours?
Okay. I think that's all the time we have, right, John? That's all the time we have. Thank you, Murray.
Yeah. No problemo.
Yeah.
I'll go ahead and get started.
What?
Wait. Murray, stop. Please, there's the door thing. There's some money. I think money's a thing.
You drive a hard bargain.
Oh.
I'll trade you the door for $15. That's for less than the price of a cup of coffee.
Where do you get your coffee?
$10.
$5. I don't know.
$2, that's my final offer.
You can just say no.
It's his final offer.
John. Open air.
No. No. I'm so sorry.
But,
hey, you know, thank you very much. Have a great day.
But.
Huh?
Please. It's my first day on the job. I need to find someone who will trade with me. I just gotta make a trade today.
Okay. I think I know someone who can help. I have a friend who has his own restoration company. They could probably use a door that's, you know, vintage.
Yes. Oh, there you go. Huh?
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. You're a lifesaver. Oh. Look out, world! Here comes Murray Lohman!
It's Bible Story Time with Kellen!
Kellen!
How's it going, friend?
Not too shabby.
You got a Bible story for us today?
I do. Our story today comes from the book of John, and it's one of the more famous stories of Jesus in the Bible. Can you guys help me out?
Absolutely.
Great, because it's time for another edition of Human Head Puppet Theater. When Jesus crossed the Sea of Galilee, a huge crowd followed him.
Oh, don't look now, Jesus. But I'd say we got company. And by company, I'd say we got 1, 2, 300, 400, 600, 3,000, 4,000, carry the one. Yeah, Yeah, it looks like we got over 5,000 people who followed us. Easy.
Jesus said to Philip, "Where can we buy bread for these people to eat?"
A good one, Jesus. Where can we buy bread for all these people? That's hilarious. Wait, are you serious? You are serious. Jesus, listen, suppose we bought enough bread to give all of these people at least one bite, just one single bite of food. Just suppose we did that. That would take like half a year's pay. I don't know who the budget guy is, but I'm sorry, I don't think we can swing that.
Jesus already knew what he was going to do before he asked Philip. He just wanted to see what Philip would say. It's hard sometimes to believe something can happen when it seems impossible. Now, another disciple, Andrew, he spoke up.
Jesus, it's me, Andrew. We found this kid.
Hey, Jesus.
He has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish.
You can have them.
Yeah.
If it'll help.
Oh, I just don't know how far this will go with a crowd this size.
Jesus then told the disciples to have the crowd sit down. When they did, Jesus took the bread, he gave thanks for it, and he started handing it out. And then he took the fish, gave thanks, and started handing it out as well. And that's when something amazing happened.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. So just pass this around. Okay. Bread?
Oh. Mmm. This is good.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Yes, would you like some?
Well, somewhat. Oh, yes, don't mind if I do.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow, fish? Here you go.
Ooh. Bread and fish.
Do you have any more, Jesus?
Wow. Whoa. Is this all the food I brought?
Yeah. Well, do you want any more?
Oh, no, I'm full.
Wow. He said he's full.
Jesus had just done the impossible. He had taken a small amount of food that a young child was willing to share, gave thanks, and then somehow over 5,000 people had enough to eat. And check this. After that, Jesus told the disciples to gather up all the food that was left. There were 12 baskets of food left over.
Wow. I gotta pack my lunch more often.
The end.
Man, what an amazing story.
It is. There was a kid that didn't have much, but he offered what he had. And Jesus was able to take that small gift and feed a giant crowd of people.
Good stuff, Kellen. Thanks.
No doubt. I'll see you guys next time.
You know, if I'm honest, I sometimes feel like Philip. If a problem seems too big, I feel like it can't be fixed.
Yeah, me too.
But that kid used what he had to help others and trusted God to do the rest.
Yeah. And we all have something we can use.
Yeah, indeed. In fact, reveal the question. Yeah. What do you have that you can use to help others?
It may seem like you don't have a lot, but you don't need a lot to help others. Mm-hmm. You can give someone your time. Mm-hmm. Maybe a grandparent needs someone to spend time with them.
Or maybe you can help by standing up for someone who's being picked on or treated unfairly.
Yeah, you can give clothes or toys away to kids who don't have as much as you.
Yeah, lots of things.
Yeah, so talk about it with each other. What do you have that you can use to help others?
Thanks for giving us a few minutes of your time and hanging out with us.
And we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show.
Yes, we will. See ya. No! No!
Hey.
Oh.
6.
That one went off my hat onto your face. Redfish gives you wings.
No. 7, 8. I got 2 and 1.
Man, I only got 4. I thought we were going to crush it, man. Oh, we were like on a roll there.
Ooh. There we go.